Now we are going to discuss Lagrangian identity. So what is Lagrangian identity? It is a relation between dot cross product. If x1, x2, x3, y1, y2, y3 belongs to real number system, then x1 y1 plus x2 y2 plus x3 y3 whole square plus x1 y2 minus x2 y1 square plus x1 y3 minus x3 y1 whole square plus x2 y3 minus x3 y2 whole square is equal to x1 square, x2 square, x3 square into y1 square, y2 square, y3 square. So this is a Lagrangian identity in the form of component of vector x and vector y, that is real number system. So this is known as Lagrangian identity. Now, if we take vector x is equal to x1, x2, x3 and vector y is equal to y1, y2, y3, then vector form of Lagrangian identity is, if we see from the above form, that is x dot y modulus value whole square plus cross product of x dot y with modulus square is equal to modulus value or magnitude of vector x square, magnitude of vector y square. So this is the Lagrangian identity in vector form. If we see where x dot y is x1 y1, x2 y2 plus x3 y3. And second part, x cross y is x2 y3 minus x3 y2 comma x3 y1 minus x1 y3 comma x1 y2 minus x2 y1. So if we take the magnitude of these vectors, we will get the same as occurring Lagrangian identity, and also mod x square is x1 square plus x2 square plus x3 square, and mod y vector is y1 square, y2 square, y3 square. So the above form is a Lagrangian identity in the vector form. Now we will discuss the problem. If vector x and y are unit vectors and dot product of x and y is 0, then prove that x cross y is a unit vector. Now, the solution is, as x and y are unit vector, then determine magnitude value of x and magnitude value of y is 1. Then using Lagrangian identity, we get magnitude value of x cross y whole square plus magnitude value of x dot y whole square is equal to modulus x square and modulus y square. So substituting all the values as we have to find magnitude of x plus y to prove which unit vector x dot y is 0, so it is 0, it is 1, 1 square is 1 and 1 square is 1. So we get modulus value of x cross y whole square is 1. So we get modulus value of x cross y is 1. Negative value is rejected because modulus value is always positive. Therefore, x cross y is equal to 1 gives x cross y is a unit vector. So this was our required result by using Lagrange identity.